In this video, we introduce the idea of a secant line for a function f of x on a given interval. We learn to compute the slope of a secant line, and we work an example of computing the equation of a secant line. So we start out with the definition of a secant line for f of x on an interval a to b. And we see in our diagram that we have some arbitrary function f of x, and we have two x values labeled, a on the left, connected to a y value of f of a, and b on the right connected to a y value of f of b. And the secant line for f of x on this interval is just the line passing through those two points on the function. So the line passes through those points, a f of a and b f of b. And we'd like to get a formula for the slope of the secant line. And that's just the rise over the run between these two points. So the rise is just the difference in y coordinates, and that's going to be f of b minus f of a. And the run is the difference in x coordinates, and that's just b minus a. And we quickly arrive at our formula for the slope of a secant line. So there it is. The slope of a secant line on an interval a to b is just given by f of b minus f of a, all divided by b minus a. So now we can work a quick example of finding the slope of a secant line on a specific function. And we're going to extend this problem to actually finding the equation of that secant line, and we'll go ahead and put that in slope-intercept form. So we start working on our slope of the secant line, and that's going to be f of b minus f of a in the numerator. Well, in this case, b is 2 and a is 1, so I have f of 2 minus f of 1. And then we divide by the length of that interval, in other words, the difference in x coordinates, and that's 2 minus 1. So we have to compute f of 2. And with this formula, 0.5 times x squared, if we sub a 2 into that, we get 0.5 times 2 squared. That's 0.5 times 4, which is just 2. Now f of 1 is obtained by plugging in x equals 1 into the formula for f of x, and we get 0.5 times 1 squared, which is just 0.5. So now we have to clean things up, and in the numerator we get 1.5, or you could write it as 3/2, and in the denominator we have 1. Well, dividing by 1 doesn't change anything. So the slope of the secant line is 1.5. So now we want to get the equation of the secant line that passes through these two points. And to get this done, we're going to use the point slope formula, just as a quick reminder. We normally write that as y minus y0 equals m times x minus x0, where x0, y0 is a known point on the line, and m is the slope. So we already know that our slope is 1.5, and then we can choose either one of the known points on this curve. And I'll go ahead and use 1 f of 1. So the x coordinate there is 1, and the y coordinate is f of 1, which again is 0.5. So subbing into the point slope formula, we have y minus 0.5 is equal to 1.5 times x minus 1. Now to get this in slope-intercept form, which is generally the easiest way to graph things, all we have to do is solve for y. So I'm going to do two things at once. I distribute the 1.5 over the x minus 1, and that gives me 1.5x minus 1.5. And at the same time, I'm going to add the 0.5 to both sides to isolate y. So I have a plus 0.5. Finally, I clean things up, and I have y equals 1.5x minus 1. So we'll go ahead and verify this is the correct equation by plugging this formula into our plotting software. And when we do that, we see that our line does pass through the two points that were given on this function, so it's the correct equation of the secant line. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.